Hello guys, if you are like me, having a car like this, Toyota Corolla Verso, or any other Toyota or another car. Oh, door was locked. On all cars there is a small panel, which contains a plastic lid which is not in use. On my Toyota, there is someone like this as well, so we are now going to install a USB contact over here. USB plug, maybe it's the correct word. So I will take this panel with me inside and do the installation. Then we take it out, it's just two latches, hooks or something. And then we release the two plugs. And we take this with us inside. I did order the USB from eBay or Amazon, and it looks like this. Comes with a cable. And the USB B. Let's see if Mr. Cannon can do this. Looks like this. And it can be opened. So it has a dual USB. Yeah, here we go. Yes. And to make that fit in the frame, we have to do some slight modification onto this edge. We need to remove this plastic lid, which is kind of pressed onto this. And here it is. Then, to make it fit, the width is perfect, but the height is a little too high for the Toyota. So we need to trim it down, the bottom and on the top, just so slightly. I use a small knife. Be careful with your fingers when you do this. One side down, just a small test. And voila, here it is. Fantastic. That was easy. Let's see how it works. Okay, this is how it looks like when it's already installed in the plastic. I had to make a small notch in here because of this strap that's hold the plastic lid. Let's remove this one. And on the back side as well. Looks like it's made for the Toyota, almost. You also get it in blue, and I think it was green as an option as well. Then we need to connect it to the car. And to connect it to the car, this is a really good choice. You remove one of the fuses in the fuse box, put the fuse in here, and then put this one in place, and then you have your separate fuse for your USB together with the cable you just got inside there, which was included. Here is also a fuse inside, which is a glass fuse like this. Let's see how much this is on. This is a fast blow 10 amps. This one screws to the earth, metal place on the car, of course. I will cut this one off and put this one on here, and we have this one on. So, then, back to the car. Okay, back in the car. I have now managed to install the two wires, cables, the red one and the black one. The black one I managed to screw. Let's see if you can see something in the darkness. Screw it on the screw on the metal, the chassis of the car. And the red one, let's see if we can make it zoom in here somewhere. And here you can see it. I have tapped the fuse, remove the fuse, place it in the holder. You see the red one. And then the cable is connected to the ignition. So when that work is done, then it's just plug and play. So now it's just putting the panel back in place, the two original connectors, and then this black and red. The blacks go to the brass fitting and the red goes to the metal one. Here it is. And then just snap it in place. There we go. Done. A test. This is how it looks like, people. Look at it. Ignition on. Excellent, eh? And if I start the car. volt. That is simply amazing. Job well done. Then you got myself a dual USB with the blue quick charge 3.0 connections. Just fantastic. I'm happy with it. Works like a charm. Tested both with my GPS and my phone and everything is just excellent. If you have any questions about the installation, just let me know in the comments below. I will also provide links for the parts in the comments. No, not in the comments, in the description below the clip. As usual. Done. See you guys. Thanks for watching again. Bye.